Hey, I'm Sideways Thinker, back again with some more Let's Play Penumbra Blind. Ooh. Open up. Okay, they've given us rocks, so these rocks got to be for something. Nope. Well, this seems useless, so let's head back out here. Oh god, they got down these loading screens. Get the old hammer out in case we run into anything nasty. I can hear something moving. Saw something over there. Oh, Jesus. See if I can kill it. Oh, bugger. No, go away. I'm dead. Fuck. Okay. Yes, there's something else down here with us. However, got a rock. Rock, is it? I know you're still here, dog. You dead? Okay. I don't trust this thing. But we'll move on. It's really not that scary if, when you know you can just throw rocks at the damn thing till it falls down. Okay, workshop, office. What lies down this path? The workshop. Locked. Great. Continue down this winding path. See, these have got to actually be leading somewhere. No, it keeps pointing me in the way of the workshop. Office. This is where I've just been. No, it is not. I can switch that off. Light. I miss being outside already. This place is starting to get to me, but even if I could reach that grate, it looks built into the rock itself. No way it's coming loose. It's quite a building, that. Really. Well, we can just randomly search the ground. Nothing in here with me, I hope. Locked, I need a key. In here. Oh, what's that? Beef jerky. Now, my experience with the occasional Silent Hill game would tell me, well, at least the comments I've read from other people's Let's Plays of them, would tell me that beef jerky distracts satanic dogs. But we don't need to distract it because we've got rocks. Nothing. What's this? More beef jerky. Strange office this is, really. What have we got? Well, we got satanic dogs and beef jerky. Backstrin, right. Ooh, a key. Well, first, this thing. Copenhagen Post, Monday 17th, 1930. I'm assuming that this was actually in Greenland, for some reason it's in English. Psychotropic deposits at the bottom of Death Mine? Researchers at University of Copenhagen have suggested... Copenhagen. I know I'm pronouncing this wrong, but fuck it. Have suggested that mind-altering chemicals naturally seen into the rock may be the cause of the high suicide rates at the Greenland mine. The university, which has recently been conducting studies into isolated communities, first became interested in the workers... Sorry, I need a drink. Ugh. Of the Northwestern Lead Mine last year. Lead? My God, of course they're committing suicide. They're going crazy. They discovered that even taking into account Greenland's naturally high suicide rate, local figures for the last 100 years were abnormally high at 46 deaths per 100,000 populace, compared to the national average of 29. On further investigation, experts diagnosed many of the miners symptoms in common, I don't know why I'm stuttering so badly on this, with early stages of paranoid schizophrenia. This has prompted researchers to hypothesize that natural deposits of lysergic acid, a pH 4 formula recently discovered to have hallucinogenic properties, may be present in the rocks. Few locals were conducive to the interview, but those who agreed to speak had their own explanation. Inuit spirits known as the Twingail, live in the mountains. The university awaits the results of chemical testing studies continue. Interesting. And a key. Nope. Ah, batteries. Nope. That's it for this page, finally. Okay. The 15th of August, 1945. Commander Burke, Emergency Airstrip Zulu, Weekly Report. Another unremarkable week in Greenland, regular supply shipment received, standard emergency drills carried out, routine runaway maintenance completed, I have ordered maintenance to be carried out twice weekly from here on in due to increased snowfall, one wounded. The one wounded figure is no cause for concern back in London. The Germans haven't extended their front line by 4,000 miles. Two of my men were caught manufacturing cherry bombs in our workshop and armory, and succeeded in blowing off a couple of fingers. I take partial responsibility for this in that I allowed them access to the demolitions manual we keep in the storeroom, and I'm sure that's where they learnt the ingredients. As a precautionary measure, I have now locked up that manual in the chest in my office and will keep the key on my person at all times. Alright. Needless to say, both men have been disciplined and the injured man has been sent home for medical care. I cannot think that a more suitable punishment would have been for him to stay out here, but the matter is out of my hands. The base is so disconnected sometimes, I feel as if this war could end and we might not even hear about it out here. Supplies requisition order. Dynamite for excavation purposes. 7 bayonets, not necessary in my opinion, but procedure states we should have a full complement. 1 industrial ice pick for removing the dam ice that forms on the external hatch. 1 pair of reading glasses. Category 7C, an order for myself. My glasses are in a rather poor state of repair and could do with some replacing. Could do with replacing, even. Reconditioning of mine continues, the structure being fortified from potential bomb damage, and excavation of previously caved areas is going ahead. One point of curiosity is some kind of archaeological find, an artifact buried in the earth and discovered by one of the work teams. Later this evening, a martial duty, after martial duty, I shall take a closer look at the artifact. It appears to be man-made, but have working and may have working parts inside. I shall remove what looks like the front cover and see if I can't discover the source of the light which constantly emanates from it. Ah. Oh, fuck.